First of all, at the outset, let me thank all those who are behind the curtain for this successful program. It is a really a wonder thing that you have conducted 188, that is a webinars. That is a really wonderful thing. That is for homeopathy. So let me start with, since it is a small group, I do not know whether the organizers will allow an interactive session.
We will have a presentation. After that, we will have an interactive section.
Okay.
Can have your presentation, doctor. Right. Then after the presentation, we will allow those who wish to ask questions or wish to ask, make comments, will be allowed to make comments upon raising their hands.
So let's go ahead.
Yeah.
So... So our session is today's session is management, homeopathic management of ulcers. And as we know, by definition, ulcer means a breach in the continuity of epithelium of either skin or mucous membrane. Now, most of the time, the breach in mucous membrane is not visible outside. Okay. But a breach in skin is visible for others. And this is a more troublesome point of the whole affair. So now the ulcers could be, classification, depending upon the pathology, it could be classified as vascular. And vascular could be either arterial or venous, or the ulcer could be also neurogenic, infective. Most of the time, the infective is origin is bacterial or fungal, and very, very rarely, a viral infection gives rise to a chronic ulcer, very rarely. And then the next cause is traumatic, and finally, neoplastic. So these are the classification based on pathology. So now, the whole session, I'm just going to present the cases of this ulcer and how I treat it. Okay. So this is a 67-year-old person, a nearby place which is known as Kootapanai, Tirunelveli, presented with a painful ulcer in the left foot since 3 months. Pain is aggravated at night. He has also got numbness of the lower extremity, especially which is at night. This gets worsened while walking and lying on sides. And this is ulcer. Okay, what you are able to see here is a metatarsal bone. Okay, this was the presentation, what he was having. And a closer look at it. So I want to just show you how, some. Okay. And the history of presenting complaint. The patient was a diabetic. Okay. And 3 months before, he got an injury on the left lifted toe and took some herbal external application. But his condition worsened and he went to an allopathic hospital nearby his house where the toe was amputated. Patient developed a gangrene over the amputated site and referred to Chennai hospital where it was diagnosed as vascular obstruction and advised to undergo vascular surgery, which requires nearly 8 hours of anesthesia. The son went and asked the surgeon whether my father will withstand this 8 hours of anesthesia. So the surgeon told, we cannot assure on that. If he withstands, well and good. And the son asked, if he does not withstand, no, we cannot guarantee anything on that. So the son decided, okay, let me have a trial with homeopathy. That's what how people come, you know, the last resort in homeopathy. So the past illness, he had at the age of 13 years, he developed a chickenpox. 32 years of age, he had a fracture of leg. And 64 years of age, operated for a, you know, cataract. And the family history, the brother and mother, both were diabetic. Brother and father are also hypertensive. One brother was insane and another brother was having bronchial asthma. So we are able to see, you know, from that strong family history of a miasmatic trend is there. And personal history, he's a non-vegetarian, smoking 35 to 45 cigarettes per day. And to add that, he also consumes alcohol every day. But since 2 months, he has stopped. And these are the physical generals. Appetite diminished, thirst increased for cold water, sleep disturbed due to pain, and stools are regular, urine increased frequency to pass, which is again aggravated at night, sweat increased over the head and chest, besides cold food and drinks, sweets and alcohol. The arterial Doppler study was done in some other hospital, and that was showing, you know, diffuse, irregular, endymal thickening, fibrofatty plates, calcified plates, focal arterial calcification, atherosclerotic changes involving the entire left lower limb arterial system. See, this is one of the most difficult part of treating it. We have, you know, totally nearly 90 to 98% luminal occlusion. And an MR angio was also done, which was saying that, you know, even it is trans, you know, it's going upward, up to ascending arch and thoracic abdominal aorta appears normal, except for mild atherometous changes. Okay, so that was arterial changes. And both the side he has got. And final impression, the above findings are suggestive of peripheral, femoral, popliteal, vaso-occlusive. And the diagnosis was made dry gangrene with a peripheral vaso-occlusive disease and diabetes mellitus. Would anybody like to try a medicine? Okay. So anyway, what I have done, so these are the rubrics which are taken, and we have taken, you know, Bogar Bonihasan. Okay, because this is a condition where the pathology of thickening of the artery is there, found in many places. So that's what we have taken Bogar Bonihasan therapeutic pocket book, sorry. Characteristic repertory, and we have come with these are the rubrics which are taken: circulation, blood vessel, heart, sclerotic, thickened, skin and exterior body, gangrene, cold, skin and exterior body, ulcer, gangrenous, skin and exterior body, ulcer, sensitive, appetite, desire for alcoholic liquors, appetite, desire sweets, appetite, desire cold water, condition in general, aggravation time at night, and lower extremity numbness. And this was the repertorial totality and repertorial result we got. And we have started with the arsenicum, album, and treatment started with arsenic album 0 bar 3 QDS. Then the potency was raised to 0 bar 6 and 0 bar 12. Over a period of 6 months, patients showed improvement both in ulcer and in diabetes. So we will see the improvement in the ulcer. So this was the condition when he has come, and we have done some amount of what you call debriding. And you will be able to see, this is, see that, we have seen that the bone was nibbled with the help of our surgeon, because an osteomyelitic bone will not allow the whole thing to heal. So I have taken help of a surgeon who has nibbled the bone. While nibbling and referring back to me, he has said to me, vascularity is adequate. That was a wonder after homeopathic treatment. And a closer look at it. This was another stage. And this is how we have produced a result with homeopathy. So case one. Let us move to case two. So this was Mr. K, aged 35 years. He belongs to Kulachekaram, where do I practice? And this was a presentation on 79-04, presented with a complaint of non-healing ulcer since 2 years over the left heel. The ulcer is punched out and very offensive. See, this offensiveness, that time we had our college dressing room was in first floor. And people who were taking medicine in the ground floor, they could get the stench of it. So that offensive it was when the ulcer was opened in the first floor, those who are standing at the ground floor, they could get the stench of it. There is no pain in spite of, we putting a scoop inside and removing all the debris. There was no pain for him. The ulcer has started after patient has gone out of bed and started using his leg after a paraplegia, which was followed after he has fallen in a well and injured the spinal cord. So this was ulcer. See what you are able to see, that white thing. Okay, that was a calcaneus bone. And a small ulcer is also seen in the medial aspect. So this is a heel. This is another view. See, this is a typical trophic ulcer, a neurogenic ulcer. He has also got incontinence of urine and prolapse of rectum following the injury to spinal cord. Along with this complaint, he has had fullness of the abdomen and flatulence, which get aggravated after pernicious food. And past history, there was asthma in childhood, which gets aggravated during moon phases, cold exposure. And as he has changed his residence, this problem spontaneously got settled. Family history, asthma for his brother and one of the sisters, and rheumatism in mother. And physical general, increased sweat over the palms and soles, and thermally he has aversion to both extremes of temperature and prefers fan in summer, prefers covering in all season with moderately thick clothes, and desires cold water bathing. There is a craving for fish and punctured things. And mentally, he is very optimistic and easily get irritated while being contradicted. He was also having artistic talent, including stage performance of drama and music concert. He has got a very sharp memory. And this was on examination, the size of ulcer, 4 cm and 4 cm, with a depth of 5 cm, and the margins are punched out and the floor is by the necrotizing bone. There is no sensation. A sterile scoop was introduced during the dressing and the necrotized bone was scooped out without anesthesia. There was also another small ulcer present near the medial aspect of the foot. Once again. And the diagnosis was made as a post-paraplegic trophic ulcer. Anybody suggestion for a medicine? Okay, let me go ahead. With this presentation, what I initially thought it was a pleuric acid. Pleuric acid 30 was given for 2 days. And there was no improvement because as far as myself is concerned, if there is an improvement in the ulcer, the first thing is the offensiveness has to come down. So in spite of 2 days, there was no relief in offensiveness. So I changed the medicine to RMET and there was no progress. The offensiveness was still continuing. So I thought of reconsidering the drug. And the miasmatic interpretation was given as syphilitic miasm because of the punched out ulcers and the necrotic bone, necrosis up to bone. Okay, on 21-9-2004, the case was given Merxol 0/6, that is a 50 millisimal potency, TDS. And following this, the offensiveness has drastically reduced within 2 days. Merxol was continuous for another 5 months in 0/12 and 0/30 potencies. And this was the result which Merxol has produced. Okay, how nicely healed. Yeah. For your information, this case was very interesting for me because this case is reported to me in an evening hour. When he has come, he was fully drunk. So I told him, I will not be able to see you at this condition. You come next day when you are sober. So the next day he came and he abused one of the surgeons and told me that that fellow is asking me to, you know, go ahead with the amputation of my leg. This is how, you know, homeopathy saves one from amputation of the leg. So later on, I have given sulfur as a constitutional remedy. With that, even the patient improved in incontinence of urine and prolapse of rectum. And for your information, till now, there is no, you know, these neurogenic ulcers tend to get, you know, repeated or, you know, they can come back. But till now, no recurrence. Yes. And in this case, I will discuss later. So now the third case. So this is again a 63-year-old presented with the complaints of non-healing, multiple ulcer for a period of 4 years over the left leg in the calf region. There used to be occasional burning and a watery sticky discharge. Since 3 days, patient has also developed itching all over the body with burning, which is aggravated early morning, 3 to 4 a.m., aggravated by warmth and sweating, and ameliorated by cold bathing. He's also having burning micturition. Patient has also got fullness of abdomen, which is aggravated by eating as soon as. For the ulcer, he has taken allopathic and Ayurvedic treatment, which gives a temporary relief, but no completely cured. He has been also taking treatment for hypertension and knee pain. And 5 years back, he had got an attack of chikungunya. Patient as a person is very fastidious, cooperative, very proud, easily angered. And after the disease, he has got a lot of anxiety. And, you know, he is also aggravated. His, you know, that anger is aggravated by contradiction. He want to be magnetized and desire to be in open air. He desires cold food and drinks. This was a physical examination. Ulcer, multiple ulcers on the left leg, 16 numbers. Base is muscle and the fluid has a dark blackish colored granules. No pain and no localized lymphadenopathy. This was a lab investigation, and very interestingly, or you know, this is a finding. We have done a KOH mounting of the ulcer, and there was a presence of a fungal hyphae. So the diagnosis was a mycetoma and ulcer. The following totality was taken: mine company desire for, mine fastidious, mine hearty, contradiction intolerant of, and certain skin symptoms. What came up was sepia, phosphorus, arsenic album, lycopodium, and sulfur. And arsenicum album was selected and given in 0/3 potency and was repeated for a period of from 2010 to 3/9/2010. Then the potency was raised to 0/6 from period of someone is marking to 8/9/2010, and the ulcer healed within this time. You are able to see how these ulcers. Okay, and this is finally we are able to produce this type of healing, and pigmentation was there. See that blackish, granules. So this is a fungal ulcer. And case number 4, I will present. This is 41-year-old male who has come with lower extremity since 1.5 months, ulcer, painful and oozing. Started with a reddish discoloration and then blisters form. See, he had a fever. Following that, he had developed the whole thing. So now the pain was there, which was aggravated by first movement, aggravated by exertion, and there was amelioration by rest. And history of presenting illness, patient had a fever and chilliness 1.5 months back. Along with this, he has developed a redness and swelling of the leg. Consulted an allopathic hospital where they did surgery and the patient developed the ulcer. He was treated and then advised by the doctor to undergo a skin grafting, which he cannot afford because it was costing him, already costed him nearly 50,000, and he is supposed to pay another 1 lakh for his hospital. So he is not able to afford. And these are the generals. And mental state, easily angered. And he desires company. He is an introvert, irritable, fastidious, and worried about his financial problem. And he desires sour, spicy thing, desires fanning in summer and cold bathing, cigarette smoking 6 per day, alcohol once in a week. Physical finding. Anemia, mild pallor was there, and he was only weighing 48 kgs. Ulcer examination. This was ulcer, it was a very big ulcer, 13 centimeter into 11 centimeter, extending from the malleolus to above. Edges are punched out, floor with the granulation tissue, base is the bones. See the extent of ulcer. Okay. And the depth also you can see. Okay. This is the extent of the ulcer. And from the other side. Okay. And you are seeing a small projection like here. Okay, and that area was a pulsating. So that was a the tibial artery which was going for pulsation. Okay, so that depth it was. Anybody to suggest medicine? So let me see what I have done. Okay, this was a result we are able to produce. Yeah, this was the final outcome of it. No? Not even 10,000 rupees he has spent. Not even 10,000. Okay, there is 1 lakh and where is 10,000. Okay. So let us go for the next case. So now here, initially I did not have any, you know, clue of prescribing. So I put him on Zaclac for 3 days because he was already, you know, first I have started with, you know, Rustox because I was, you know, only that modality basis. Then, you know, the case was left. On 8th, I started with, you know, Hepercel. Okay. And 0/6 QID. Then I went ahead till, you know, 31st. And I left him for some time. And with the Zaclac. And again, on 16/2/2009, he has come with a profuse bleeding of the granulation tissue. And still his, you know, sensitiveness, the sensitiveness was still remained. So I changed. There is a bleeding tendency. I changed the medicine to Lachesis. And finally, you have seen what was the outcome. Okay, that was our outcome. Okay. So here I did not stick with only single medicine. I need to change the medicine. I use the 3 medicines. Now, case number 5, Mr. T. H. Shaji, I am till up to 9:30, my presentation. Am I right?
Yeah, you can proceed, doctor.
So, this is about Mr. T., aged 62 years, male patient, came to our OP for the complaints of large non-healing offensive ulcer. Duration is for 3 years, which appeared after surgical removal of his right second toe. His signs and symptoms was massive ulceration with pain, oozing of blood sometimes with offensive watery discharge. Pain is aggravated by walking. Pain also, he had also had a burning pain accompanied with the numbness of the surrounding area. The ulcer was irregular in shape. Patient also complained of recurrent spraining of the ankle. He has also got itching of the anus and history of presenting complaints. 7 years before, patient was apparently normal. Complaint gradually started and the patient known to be diabetic and was under diabetic treatment. Ulcer started in the first toe and the toe was removed surgically, yet then the ulcer has not healed. History of previous illness with the treatment adapted. Known to be diabetic more than 7 years, known to be hypertensive for 18 years, and he has also got a hemorrhoid history 30 years back to allopathic treatment, and he has also taken homeopathic treatment also. The family history, we couldn't elicit, rather than no irrelevant, we couldn't elicit much because he was very, you know, very introvert. And this was his generals. He decides cold food, cold climate and fanning. Mental generals, altered mental disposition that does not decide to do any work. And physical finding, and his RBS was 202. And this was ulcer. Actually, there was a, no, this ulcer, when you see that, you know, he it has developed over a fibrotic area. Okay. Anybody from that shape and size of the ulcer, anything you can find out? Okay, it was a malignant ulcer. Okay, what we call it as Marjoni's ulcer. And the repertorial totality was taken up, burning, foot sore, extremities, cramp, lower limbs, extremities, numbness, insensibility, perspiration, profuse, extremities, dislocation, sprain easily, mouth discoloration, painless, and rectum, itching of anus, and mind indifference, everything too. And this was the outcome: arsenicum, phosphorus, sepia, calcarea, lycopodium. And this was the repertorial result. These four medicines we have taken up for a differentiation. And after medication, see, it is changing. Changes there. And finally, this is what we have produced. So that is, already scar he has got, fibrotic area, and it is healed. Oh, this is case number six, very interesting lady. Actually, she has come with that leg is an elephantiasis leg. Okay. And she has developed an ulcer over this. So this is lymphatic ulcer. And this ulcer, it really took me a lot of problem. Because in spite of trying with all our medicine, like Hepercel, Mercurius, and what all I have used for ulcers, I have given fluoric acid, I have given Rustac, what you call Aromatalicum, I have given, nothing was working. The ulcer was still remaining. So it was the greatest problem for me, because the patient was admitted and she is not improving. And in between, what happened, elephantiasis, or what you call that filariasis, get reactivated. So she has come with chills and rigors, and there was an intermittent fever-like symptoms. Okay. Now what to prescribe? So one day, my intern was telling me, sir, this lady seemed to be advising me that you should get a love marriage. You should go for a love marriage. And I was wondering why this lady has to tell that small girl to go for love marriage. So then I understand this lady is the one, they belong to a different caste. And she eloped with a belonging to a high, class family. She eloped with a man who has come to do some sort of carpentry work in their house. This stuck me. And, I gone ahead with, Natrum Muriaticum in this case. And what Natrum Muriaticum has done, I'll show you what Natrum. 1 minute, please give me a time. 1 minute.
Okay.